Howdy folks, how you doing? Kel here. Well, what are we doing today? We're going to smoke a Macanudo Maduro. I've been looking for a kind of a more mild Maduro cigar, more mild cigar period actually. I smoked a Romeo and Juliet Vintage, and those are really nice, expensive though. And these aren't exactly cheap. These are like, I paid $8.10 for this cigar through JR Cigars. It's a single. Singles are more expensive, but they're like $140 for a box of 25, which I guess isn't too bad, $24, $25. I think they're five something, so they're not real cheap, but here it is. Let me give you a little picture of it, a little close-up view of it here. See what it looks like. It's got a very oily wrapper. That it says it's an oily Connecticut broadleaf wrapper. A little nose here on it. I guess it's got Mexican tobacco inside, I guess. It didn't say on JR, but on Cigars International it said it had Mexican tobacco. This is a 5.5 by 49 ring. It's the Hyde Park model, and so that's that. Back to me. Anyway, this cigar has an interesting smell to it. It's clearly Maduro, but it also it reminds me of something from a long time ago. Maybe the first Macanudo I smoked has a very robust kind of pungent wrapper. Maybe more cigar-y than most Maduros are. Now, actually, I've been looking for a kinder, gentler Maduro cigar one that I can smoke once in a while. Something that's not quite so powerful as, say, a Vargas Black or even the Series N by even the Series N by Miguel Cabana. And I was reading about Macanudos. I did do a review of a regular Macanudo, by the way. I was reading about Macanudos, and they said they're generally more of a mild cigar, and this, I guess, is more medium to mild. Let's see here. That didn't work out well. Oh my. My wrap is trying to come loose on me because, sorry, kind of gross. Wrapper was trying to come loose, had to fix that. But the cut was kind of a crappy cut on my part. But it's very, 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 very nice. The draw is wonderful. I feel a draw should be easy enough. I'm going to cut one more time here. Kind of feel like a draw should be easy enough that if I wanted to, I could lay in a pool, stick the cigar up out of the water, and still breathe. That's how easy I like to draw to be. Not everyone would like that, but I do. Get all the little pieces out of here, too. Wet it down a bit, because I've cut the cap completely off this plant. But that's pretty good. Not quite as easy as I'd like. It seemed like it was better than when I first drew one. Now it seems to be less good. But it's alright. It'll work. Like I said, I've been looking for a Maduro cigar with a little milder. I'm going to have to do this down here because my lighter is not good in the wind. I should just use a torch. I've got a good torch that my sister-in-law sent me, my former sister-in-law. I still think her as my sister-in-law. No, I'm sorry, I'm going to have to. Gonna have to switch to the Bic. That little lighter it's got a nice little small cloth flame, which is good generally, but frankly, in the wind like this, and it doesn't probably look very windy here, but it's windy right now. Trying to get it so the wind blows the flame to the edge of the cigar, and while I turn the cigar and light just the edge in the way that I do. It's blowing the flame back on my thumb and burning me. I should bring my torch out next time, this time of year. This time of year, just it's windy every damn day, it seems like. It sucks for cigar smoking, by the way. And it really certainly sucks for lighting. Now it stopped all of a sudden. All right. Now we're getting there. Now we're getting it. And now the wind's back again. You know, if you've seen some of the videos, you've noticed I had a lot of bright sun shining on my right hand side of my face. Left-hand side of your screen, and it's kind of annoying this time of day, 6 o'clock, six o'clock or so. The sun's setting over there and it's right on my face every time. She didn't like. Today I came out here and sat down to make this video and there I was again, right in my eyes, and she, you know, I've had enough. I've had enough of this nonsense. Between this lighter here and this lighter here, one big difference is with this one here, I can light this like this and leave it lit. I'm not touching anything. With that one, with that big lighter, it's kind of a pain in the butt because I've got to hold my finger in the thing and it gets hotter and hotter. I burn my tongue with my thumb almost every time when I light a cigar. Well, let's see here. Well, at first glance, I'm not really that impressed so far. I was really hoping that this was a cigar when I ordered it on that cigar with, by the way, the help of my Patreon people, and thank you very much, guys. This is the first order I got from Jera Cigars, and this one was the one I was really, really kind of excited about because they're expensive. I thought they'd be really, really good, and so far I wasn't a very good. I didn't really think much of that. Usually the first quarter inch is, you know, maybe the best part of the cigar. I guess the binder and the long filler is Mexican, so we've got a bit of an illegal alien problem here. Crossed the border illegally in my country and became a cigar. I gotta say, I'm not really too impressed so far. You know, maybe just me, but it is fairly mild, but what flavor I'm getting is a little bitter for my taste, I think. Of course, the draw on this thing which initially wasn't so bad, but it seems worse now. I recut it, and it still seems worse. But I don't think it's interfering with the flavors. It has got kind of a bitter, really a dark, bitter chocolate. Like, you know, chocolate you get for cooking chocolate flavor, where it's just cooking chocolate with no, you know, it's just bitter with no sweet. Let me see if I can fix this a little bit. I'm going to cut it again. I found recently here that I think maybe a lot of times cigars that are tight, the tightness is generally in the end that you cut. The last time I was smoking part of this black and I cut it in half, and then I noticed that the front part was really a good draw. The back part was still not so good. And I think it's because the tightness is in the back part where they put the cap on. At least in particles. At least in that cigar it was. I don't know. It's just a theory. I'm going to test that out. Next time I pull a particle cigar out and I cut it and it's really tight, I'm just going to keep clipping it to get to a reasonable draw. Well, it's very, you know, the first Macanudo cigar I had, I didn't care much for when I was much younger. Maybe I'm now seeing why. It was recommended by the owners. Here's my cut, by the way, and my burn. Looking pretty good. It was recommended by the owners of the Bell Pipe Shop here in Missoula at the time. That's three or four owners ago. And I found out later on that that's what they always recommended. When anybody asks what kind of cigar they smoke, I always say Macanudos, and that had a lot of Macanudo cigars. But I think that's what they smoked. You know, they weren't just trying to sell something. They smoked those cigars. And for those of you who like really coffee-flavored, strong, more bitter cigars, you know, I think this is more of a cigar for you. For me, I can tell right off the bat, it doesn't have a sweet flavor, really, note. It just has dark, You know, it's like, see, it, to me, it's kind of like dark chocolate for cooking. When I was a kid, I was a little kid. As all little kids do, I love chocolate, of course, still do. And one day I was in the kitchen and my mom was there cooking. And she had this big block of chocolate, you know, and I think it was Hershey's too, something like that. I think it said Hershey's on it or something. And she was cooking, you know. And I'm like, well, can I have a piece of that, Mom? You know, because she broke a piece off to cook with. And I thought, she's cooking with a chocolate bar. I said, can I have a piece? Can I have a piece? Can I have some chocolate, Mom? Can I have a piece of that chocolate bar? And I was probably 5 or some other thing, or, you know. And she's like, no, you wouldn't like it. I said, yeah, I would. I like chocolate. I want some of that chocolate bar, Mom. You know, can I have some, please? Pretty please? He said, okay, but you're not going to like it. So she breaks off a chunk, you know, square, about an inch square, and gives it to me, you know. And I took a big bite out of it, you know. And for any of you who have ever done that, and some of you probably did that as a kid too, let me know in the comments if you have. It was just totally bitter and nasty. That's what I found. I didn't like so much like chocolate as I like chocolate and sugar. The two had to go together. You know, it was really cooking chocolate. It's not exactly something you want to eat, not by itself. I don't know what she was cooking that day with that. Those were the days when people actually cooked with chocolate like that. Actually cooked and made things from scratch. You know. Well, it's getting a little bit better. The first few tugs, the first, you know, bit of it was, seemed kind of bitter. It's getting a little better. I'm getting, I'm getting some notes, more Maduro notes. But you know, even that puff there, when I'm not kind of growing over my face, it's just really kind of, it tastes like a, you know, if I were blindfolded, and someone lit the cigar and had me try it, I would absolutely think it was a regular cigar. I wouldn't even know it was a Maduro. I would think this was a regular, typical cigar-y cigar, the kind of cigars I do not like. And that's just a personal prejudice, by the way. If you love green wrapper cigars or light wrapper cigars, and you like them real cigar-y, you know, tasting, and a lot of you guys do, I've got kind of a sweet tooth, and I'm very sensitive to bitter taste. So, it colors my perception of cigars, I think. Maybe some of you are that way, but and there are some regular wrapper, you know, EMS type wrapper cigars, Connecticut shade wrapper cigars, I do enjoy. I had an Ecuadorian shade wrapper cigar last night. It was that La Gloria cigar, that special one they made. Did a review, and it was really nice. I like the Excalibur number 1, even that's really kind of a cigar-y cigar. You know, but that's a very light wrapper, and I really enjoy that. But this, this is a bit of a disappointment. I was expecting a really smooth, really kind of, you know, more mild, really smooth, non-bitter, chocolatey flavor type cigar. And what it is, it's more of a cigar-y cigar with a brown wrapper. You know, I don't think Macanudos are really for me. I had a Macanudo. I did a review of one a while ago, a couple weeks ago. I don't know if I posted it yet or not at this point, but it was pretty good. It was a regular cigar with a regular wrapper. It was pretty good, actually. But this, it's funny, I think I mentioned on my video where I showed you what I'd ordered from JR. And thank you once again to my Patreon subscribers. I really appreciate it. With your help, I was able to do that. But I was supposed to get 2 of these. And I was going back and forth because they're expensive, $8.10 a piece. This is the most expensive cigar I ordered in that order, frankly. This is a little cigar. This is not a big cigar. You know, it's a little cigar. And I went back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. By the way, as I'm talking to you, I'm thinking I'm going to go get a Romeo and Julieta Reserve Maduro. I have to take the taste of this out of my mouth. I'm not sure I can finish this. Anyway, though, I was mentioning in that video that I ordered 2. I was going to order 1 because we just ordered 1. Thought, well, I want to test it. I want to try them. I want to give them a fair try. I'll order 2 and, you know, just to make sure. What if one of them's plugged or something like that? I'll sell another one to smoke and review on camera and da 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 da. So I ordered 2. Then when they came in, I wasn't sure what was on the order. And as I go a lot through, I saw one cigar. I thought, oh yeah, I just got one of those. Well, last night I'm looking at the old order, and I had ordered two, and they shorted me one. So I'll be calling them tomorrow. You know what this reminds me of? I'll tell you what this reminds me of. And not in a good way. It reminds me of the Partagas Black. It really reminds me of the Partagas Black cigar. It really does. It's got that... It's got... I don't know what kind of tobacco is in. I thought Lajero was like Nicaragua. Maybe Lajero tobacco is just a type of black tobacco, I guess, when I think of it. This is a real dark cigar with... Maybe it has Lajero tobacco in it. I don't know. But it reminds me of that a bit. Only the difference is Partagas Black cigars have got this really wonderful oily wrapper, and it has sweet notes as well, caramely sweetie notes, you know, as well as a really dark, or, you know, really strong flavors. This just has the strong flavors. I was really wanting to like this cigar. And you might, if you drink your coffee black, if you'd eat chocolate without sugar in it, you know, you might like this. And I mean, this is a cigar for some people. There are guys who love cigars like this who will smoke them every day, you know. For me, it's kind of bitter to my tongue, and it just I don't have the sweetness and a flavor I like. And maybe I don't like Mexican tobacco. That could be. I don't generally buy cigars with Mexican tobacco. I didn't realize this was Mexican tobacco. Nothing against Mexico, just I've had them in the past, and I'm just not that impressed. Every region of the world has different kinds of tobacco and different kinds of soil. And when you plant tobacco on that soil, even though it's with its Cuban seeds, a lot of these modern cigars we smoke here that are quote domestic, they're from those countries that aren't Cuban, were made from Cuban seeds. The Cubans ran from the communists, and they planted these Cuban seeds in these other countries, and they're good. It's good tobacco. But every different region, the minerals and things in the soil will make the tobacco taste differently, and they all have their own little flavors. This is supposed to be, I thought, a mild cigar, but I find it quite strong for me because it's all very coffee-like, you know, more sharp, bitter taste for me, you know. And that can be good in a cigar for me. I think there's Lajero tobacco in the Lagoa Cabana series, and I'm sure there's a lot of Lajero tobacco in the Partagas Black great cigar. So I have them, last night, very strong. Not for your new beginning cigar smoker, for sure. If you want someone to never smoke cigars again, give them that cigar. I don't want anyone to smoke cigars again. But this. You know, but that those are all those both those cigars are also offset with the smoothness, you know, and a cedariness and a nuttiness that this just doesn't have for me. It just mostly like, you know, it reminds me of when a cigar wrapper doesn't burn right, and once in a while that happens. I had some cigars, a couple cigars here a week or two ago that I took right out of the five packs, and well, one was out of the five pack. Actually, one was in my humidor that got dried out a little bit. My little box, the thing was reading wrong inside. I didn't know it was less humidity than it should have been. Both those cigars had the front. I think they call it the foot. It was a bit dried out, so they didn't burn right. And I find when the wrapper doesn't burn along with the cigar, and that's why I like the way I do. I want the wrapper to burn first, and then bring the rest of the cigar along with it. So you're getting wrapper and cigar like you should get. Because I find when a cigar tunnels, or the wrapper isn't burning along with the cigar, I just get the taste of the filler and the binder, and I don't like that just by itself. You know, cigars, they say, get half of their flavor from the wrapper. And if you're just smoking the filler and the binder, well, you're not going to get a very good flavor, in my opinion. I said before, but I watched a video several years ago. There's some cigar company had three or four cigars or something, and they took two cigars, one which was a Maduro cigar, the other one which wasn't a Maduro cigar, and they had the guy smoke, try each one, then took the same cigars, they took the wrappers off and switched the wrappers, and it totally changed the way the cigar tasted. And I believe that about half the flavor is the wrapper. Maduro is not a type of tobacco, it's it's they press it and they ferment the tobacco and it gets all black like this. And that brings out the natural sugars and stuff. But this did have a strange, not quite Maduro-y smell, as I told you when I first unwrapped it, which was kind of neat in a way. You know, it reminded me of Macanudos I smoked in the past. I get this, first time I smelled the cigar, I got that sense memory. Whoa, this is like the other Maduro I smoked when I was young or something. I just had this feeling it was, you know, like something else I had. But it wasn't like, you know, when I smell the aroma of El Rey de Mundo Robusto Supremo, one of my favorite cigars of all time, or even a Partagas Black, La Gloria Cabana Series N. When I smell those wrappers, you get the same kind of similar Maduro sweet wrapper smell. This is not how that. This is all coffee. And again, if you guys like your coffee black and those kind of flavors and cigars, you love this cigar. You know, for me, it's a no-go. I actually was considering ordering a whole box of these. I didn't have the money, so I didn't. I couldn't put all my money in, you know, all my eggs in one basket, so I didn't. I don't generally want everyone to buy a whole box. I did that with Partagas Spanish Rosados, some Gigante 6x60 rings, and I've still got a bunch of them in my box because they're tight. The rolls too tight. Those aren't a bad cigar. Just usually most of them are too tight. But you know, so I've got a bunch of cigars which I smoke occasionally. I'll eventually get through, but you know, not the best choice in the world. Like I'm probably not going to buy too many more Partagas cigars because I've just had too much trouble with them. The draw on them are not to my taste, and I kind of forgive that with the Partagas Black. But there's so many other great cigars. I think, you know, I like, for instance, the Gloria Cabana Series N, which I like as much as the Partagas Black. In fact, probably more. I don't see myself putting money into those. A couple years ago, I ordered a whole box of the Partagas Black Gigante size again, 6x60 ring, and they were real nice. The throttles were pretty good on those. Not all, but they were pretty good. I figured that was because they were so, you know, such a big ring cigar. But then again, I heard the Spanish Rosado thing, oh, they'll be a nice draw too, and then they work. I've got one right now, I just tested my humidor and it's got a crappy draw, so it's like, you know, I'm a little tempted to go get one of those and smoke one of those. It's a nice flavor. Partagas blends good cigars, they just don't know how to make cigars, it's hard to say. And it's a strong thing to say, but in my opinion, they don't. You shouldn't get, you know, 30 to 50% of your cigars that have bad draws when you buy a box of cigars. Here's that cone I was talking about. See, by lighting just the end of the cigar, you see it's still burning. The wrapper burns first, and then it brings the tobacco along with it, you know. And that makes it that gets you all the flavor that you're supposed to be getting and the way you're supposed to be getting it. Try that lighting technique. And if you make a video about it, please mention my name. This is the Kel technique. I appreciate that. I've seen people use that exact technique that I know watch my channel. And then they're doing that technique, and they don't bother to mention, oh, wait, by the way, I learned this from Kel. It'll make your cigar smoking so much better. I used to have tunneling cigars and cigars that, you know, canoed where just the top part would light and stuff, all these weird things, and it was so frustrating. And then I studied and worked, and I experimented, and I finally came upon this idea of just lighting just the very ring and ring only, and it worked out really good. Still a very coffee, boy. And I would say it was tongue gremlins, but it's not, because I just took a piece of cheese and ate a piece of cheese and coated my tongue, so I wouldn't have any kind of a bitter flavors going on. Oh, it's a little lighter. Holy thing. Just can't work in this wind. I would say it's tongue gremlins, maybe, but it's not. It's the cigar. It's just too bitter for me. That's unfortunate. But like I say, you know, take my reviews with a grain of salt and understand that I like sweeter cigars, and I don't mean this to be a knock on Macanudo cigars or this particular cigar, because again, everyone's tastes are different. If you like sweeter things, if you prefer a sweeter cigar, more mild cigar, and this is supposed to be a mild cigar, but this is stronger than my Gloria Cabana Series N. It's as strong to me as a Partagas Black, in the sense it's past challenging. The Partagas Black is really strong, and it's got a lot of Lajero tobacco, and it's very dark and rich and a lot of sharp notes. And not sharp, but there's, you know, there's those bitter notes in it, you know, those strong tobacco notes. But it's offset by sweetness and by smoothness, you know. It's very strong, but it still also has some sweet notes. You see, this just has whatever long fillers are using in this cigar, it just has that one strong cigary note. You know, and it's not pleasant for me. You know, I hate to deep six this thing, but I think I'm going to talk for a few moments. We'll see if it gets any better. But it isn't for me at all. I like regular light wrapper cigars too. I like cigary cigars sometimes, depending on the brand. But not this. It just lacks that additional blend of sweetness from the Maduro wrapper that it's important to me if I'm gonna have a strong cigar. You know, like I say, I would think it was a regular cigar if I wasn't looking at it. You know, I hadn't bought it. It probably is, you know, more mild in flavor in a sense. I don't know, or something. I mean, I didn't look at the thing to see, but I think it said they're kind of mild. Not so full body, medium body or whatever, but no, it's all coffee, you know. And like you say, if you're a coffee drinker, if you kind of guy that likes your coffee black, or with no sugar, a little cream and no sugar maybe, you probably don't have very much of a sensitivity to sharp, bitter taste, and therefore you're tasting the other notes of the coffee, not the bitterness. For me, it's the opposite. I'm very susceptible to bitter flavors, and this is not good for me. It's just all bitter. It's all that bitter tobacco flavor, you know, bitter cigar flavor, which I just don't dig. You know, it's not there. The wrapper note, again, doesn't really smell much like a Maduro wrapper. It is a Maduro wrapper. It's a dark, early Maduro wrapper. You'd think it'd be fantastic. You know, that's why I ordered these. But but I can't even enjoy a little bit of a nice aroma coming off there, but not much. It's just, maybe I'm smelling also the burning of the filler. But it's not, you know how much, if you watch my videos, you know I really enjoy putting the snow on my nose and the wrapper burn or whatever drift up in my nose. And again, this is like smoking old cardboard or something, or paper. You say things like that, but boy. Well, you know, this review is over, and the cigar is finished. I smoked it a third of the way down, and it's not getting any better. It's like I'm smoking old burning bark or something. I'm smoking, it's not good. I have tried Mexican filler cigars before, and I have not been very impressed with Mexican tobacco. And I'm not saying it just because I'm against illegal immigration and stuff. I'm kidding around here. It's not that. I would love to enjoy any kind of tobacco. And there are ones I used to smoke mostly Honduran tobacco if I could get it. Honduran cigars from Honduras, you know, or cigars with a lot of Honduran tobacco in them. But I've also loved Dominican tobacco and Nicaraguan tobacco probably runs a third, though a lot of the Nicaraguan tobacco with Lajero Nicaraguan tobacco I found to be very good, excuse me. This is just not good. I don't say, I'm sorry, it's not a fun review, but we all have our tastes, and this is not to mine. This is, And it's funny because the very first, one of the very first handmade cigars I ever smoked was a Macanudo. I've been smoking, those little Wolf Brothers Croquettes, and I think I've been smoking Havana Blends too, I think, even though those came from a tobacconist. This may be one of my first hand-rolled cigars. I don't know. It seems like it was one of the first anyway. And I didn't like them then, Macanudo brand, I mean. I didn't like it then, though I have smoked a Macanudo since. On camera, I did think was okay. It was smooth and was good quality, but even that one was still a bit more too cigary and too much on the bitter side for me. to really want to buy it again. I wouldn't buy another one of those. I've got another one left in my humidor. I'll smoke it, but I've got one or two left. But this is, you know, I like my cigars to be more seedy, more nutty, more cashewy, more chocolatey, you know, sweeter, you know, and then strong. I like you know, full-bodied cigars that are full of all those flavors. And I smoked that Partagas Black last night, and boy, it's been a while since I smoked one. It was challenging. You know, it's there are times, especially when I'm drinking, if I had that Partagas Black, if I had some nice cognac, and I do know I'm just not drinking it. If I had some nice, you know, cognac, and was drinking cognac, a cigar like that it enhances the cigar and enhances the cognac, and it works together. And it's very, you know, Partagas Black is very challenging. You know, it's something. But there's the good side too, you know. It's kind of like dating a crazy girlfriend, you know. The crazy ones just love to all the time, and they'll do anything you can possibly imagine. Any sick, twisted fantasy you have, they'll indulge in. You know, you can say, "Hey, would you like to try this?" "Yeah, I'll do that." And that's God bless them, you know. God bless all sluts everywhere. You know, I've had so much fun with them. Probably because I'm kind of a slut myself, I guess. Not in a number of partners, but I've done a lot of naughty things in my day, as you know if you watch my videos. You know, and this is kind of like the crazy girlfriend, you know, the challenging, but also cheats on you. You know, it doesn't have all the rest. Dating a crazy woman, and I've dated a number of them, believe me. I think that's all I've really dated. I have bad taste in women. If you didn't know that, I've said before on camera, I have terrible taste in women. I hook up with the craziest woman you can imagine. And we're a good match, I must say, until he dumped me or acts so crazy. I've got to ruin them out of my life. Go away now. But at least with those women, you know, they're challenging and mentally interesting, and you're never bored with those women. You know, the one that really broke my heart, even to this day, I miss talking to her. I won't talk to her ever again, but I do miss talking to her, because she was exciting and interesting and very smart and very challenging. But there was also, you know, some sweetness there, and there was a girly girl quality as well, and there was all that sex. And that's what the part of this black is. This is just the black. This is the sweetness. This is like having a crazy girlfriend that doesn't like sex and isn't fun to talk to and doesn't get your sense of humor. It's just all one thing. Yeah, that just one note. Just one dark, bitter, you know, strong. Again, I gotta say again, you may love that kind of flavor. If you do, this is the cigar for you. I recommend Macanudo cigars for those who like bitter flavors, who drink their coffee black. You know, for me, it's got to be the strength and strongness of the cigar, which is challenging. If it's going to be a strong cigar, if it's going to have bitter, strong notes mixed with the wonderfulness of a sweet Maduro wrapper. The bitter and the sweet mixed together. This is just the bitter, in my opinion. Just the coffee. I guess I did drink coffee a couple times. I did, but when I drank coffee, I put cream in there, you know, and a bunch of sugar, and it wasn't too bad. But I couldn't imagine, even I didn't like it, but I couldn't imagine drinking that without sugar like some people do. I just can't imagine. And it's not bad tobacco. It's probably aged well, you know. The construction was pretty good, except it was kind of tight. And that's been kind of unforgivable. It's not really a great draw. It's an okay draw, but, and I wouldn't mind that draw if I liked the flavor. But, well, I'm going to put it down. I'm sorry, I'm just going to stop. Ugh, I'm going to go brush my teeth and wash my mouth out and smoke a good cigar, or one that I enjoy. Probably going to smoke one of my last two Romeo and Julieta Reserva Maduros. But I've got 25 more of those coming. Those will be here Thursday, and I'm glad. I had to spend my own money on them. It hurt like hell. Didn't really have any intention of spending that kind of money. But this is not for me. It may be for you. But, you know, if you don't like bitter taste, if you don't like that strong note, if you don't like black coffee taste, this won't be for you. This, you know, you can try one. I mean, you know, prove me wrong. Or prove me right. If you're a black coffee drinker, you know, go try one of these. You'd probably love it with black coffee. You'd be like, oh my God, all those rich flavors. You know, for me, it's like, ugh. You know, just, I'm tempted to draw on it again, but I'm just not going there. I'm going to say no to the cigar. I'm going to broom the cigar out of my life. It's like I'm going to broom a cheating girlfriend. Bye-bye. Go away. You're too much trouble. Too much work. Too much trouble. Even a girlfriend that loves lots of sex, if they cheat on you and make your life miserable, it's, you know. What do they say? A good woman makes your penis hard and not your life hard. And that's the thing about cigars, same thing. Not that it makes your penis hard, that you know. But, yeah. Just even a, maybe a gentle tug on it would, you know, would be better, but it's just less of the nasty coffee flavor I don't like. What a shame. Well, it's got a nice band though, and I'll keep the band and take the band off here, and I'll put that in the house and in my band collection. I've been collecting bands for years, and this one, since I'm only going to have one of these, only one of these bands, I will indeed hang on to it. But no more of those. Got a nice little band. When I was in antique business with my father, we came across an old, like, 20s or 30s ledger book, you know, with lines and ledgers and stuff or whatever. You know, it's got little leather accents in the corners. It's kind of beat up and very old, kind of musty. We found a couple of these at the garage sale. We bought them in an estate, I think, actually. And inside, someone had pasted cigar bands. Every time they smoked a cigar, they'd take the cigar band and put a little glue on it and paste it in this book. And like, I've got them stored away somewhere. We never sold them. My dad thought it was so fascinating. I kept these. I don't know where they are now. I've got some long-term storage stored. Well, I can't even get to it. There's so much stuff in there. And you know, I will keep this band just as a remembrance of the time I smoked a, sitting on their handmade. I will keep this in just to remind me of the time I smoked a cigar that I really did not like at all. Happens once in a while. You know, if every cigar review I did, I raved about how great it was and it was really nice and pretty good, you know, what would be the point of watching my videos? Nothing wrong with the cigar. It's made fairly well, you know, and it seems like it's got quality tobacco in it. Just not the kind of tobacco I would ever want to smoke again. So, that's that. And, thanks for watching. I feel bad that I couldn't say good things about it. You know, I feel bad I couldn't recommend it, but I don't. What can I say? Not all cigars are for everybody. So please subscribe anyway, and please click the bell to get notifications of my videos. Please give me a thumbs up, as that helps the channel be seen by more people. And please check out my Patreon for more cigar reviews and more talking about everything. I don't just do cigar reviews here. I talk about other stuff and make talent, politics, and all sorts of fun things. Even though I've taken the pledge, I've turned over a new leaf, cigar leaf as a matter of fact, with YouTube. Since I got those two strikes, I've decided to be more politically correct, just so you know. Some of you liberals will like that, I'm sure. I'll just paste this on my forehead to remind me to never buy another one of these. Never again. Here. Never again. I'll talk to you later.